one of the marks of slavery versus sonship that is usually very easy to see is in what people ask and what people give. A slave, by and large, is looking for the solution to a surface problem. A son is ideally looking for a solution to a root problem. And a wise father is offering resources that will address the most fundamental issues, not the most superficial issues. The cliche is, if you give a person a fish, you feed him for a day, but if you teach him how to fish, you feed him for a lifetime. A father seeks to give the most foundational resources, the letters, if you will, that somebody can build out into words and sentences and paragraphs and books and encyclopedias. This is the nature of the blessing that God gives the priest to give to the people. I want you to think about the bulk of the blessings that we encounter in our culture. People request, like a slave, mostly pain relief. They want God to heal them. They want God to bless them financially. They want God to repair a relationship. Very, very rarely do you find somebody coming to a spiritual authority and asking God to bless them with the wisdom for them to be able to work out their own problem. Now, a slave wants God to intervene at the fruit. God delights in intervening at the root. With that background, listen with a new set of ears to the very famous blessing in Numbers chapter 6, verse 22. The Lord said to Moses, "Tell Aaron and his sons, this is how you are to bless the Israelites." Not what, but how. "Say to them, the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. And the Lord turn his face toward you and give you peace." Foundationally, the priests were directing people's attention to the Lord, not to the priest. The ultimate source of all good gifts is our God and not ourselves. And I find very frequently that when people come to me begging me to give them this, that, or the other because they're in a crisis situation, it is wise for me to probe a little bit in their relationship with God. Because most of the time that desperate people are clawing at me to get something that I have to meet their surface needs, they've lost their connection with God. They've lost their focus with God. And if I resource them today, they'll want me to resource them tomorrow, and I could resource them endlessly without ever digging them out of their pit if I don't address the issue of their relationship with God. So even though I may well give them some resources, I'm going to try to open their eyes. I'm going to try to reframe their world so that they can see God once again moving in the midst of the pain in spite of their overwhelming sense of perhaps abandonment. So let's look at that again. The Lord bless you and keep you. And the Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. That second phrase deals with reconciliation with God, deals with the finest blessing being no barrier between us and the Father, that we are in right covenant relationship with him and that he delights to call us his own. That is such a stupendous perspective piece for most people. I worked with a man once who was, in his mind, a liability to his family. From the time he was very young, the family tried to hide him, tried to push him behind. Their prayer was that he would not embarrass the family when they went out to a social gathering. There was no occasion where the son was celebrated. There was no occasion where the family rejoiced in having him as a son. Rather, there was toleration on a good day, and on most days there was just that lurking fear that this son was going to mess up and embarrass the family again. And unconsciously, that man had projected the same feeling onto God, had projected the sense that because of his many sins, because of all the areas that he had failed, that God was enduring him because God had to. God was tolerating him because he was in covenant with God. God was using him in the ministry because God had gifted him and was, again, accepting the inevitable that this fellow was had to be on the playing field for a certain number of minutes, like it was a little league game. But there was that day, there was that turning point, there was that profound healing in the man when he was able to say, I finally feel as though God is proud to be my father. And that is what this blessing is trying to convey, that it's not just a covenant relationship. Yahweh is the covenant name for God, but it's not just a covenant where God blesses us, Yahweh bless you and keep you because he has to, because there's terms of agreement, because of whatever. No, Yahweh make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you because he wants to, because he delights in you, because he remembers how he made you. He still celebrates the design that he crafted, a unique, one-of-a-kind combination of spiritual and emotional and physical DNA. The Lord turn his face toward you and give you peace. At the end of the day, if God is at peace with you and his peace is resting on you, that is an immense thing. Let's go back to the apostles who were sent out two by two without their American Express card. And they were to go to the home of a worthy man, a heavyweight, a wealthy man in the community. But they were to sit in judgment on him. They were to evaluate his natural hospitality, the emotional welcome, his spiritual receptivity. And at the end of their visit, if that man did not live up to what they expected, if the standard was not met, they were commanded by God to recall their peace, for their peace to return to them, and for it not to be available for that man who they deemed not worthy. Do you understand the immensity of this last phrase? That God is looking at you, that God has come to visit you, that God during the course of this day has seen you, looked at you, and deemed you to be worthy of his peace remaining on you. That is a huge proposition, that God Almighty has turned his face towards us and has given us peace. That is the blessing that a father gives to his son. That is the kind of blessing that God delighted in giving to his people. Not a surface fix, not prosperity and all of those kinds of things, but a profound, significant blessing of relationship because he wants to be in relationship with us, and of relationship that is based on his having found us worthy of that relationship. If Father has found us worthy, if his peace is resting upon us, what else matters? Oh, the rest may still need to be addressed. There may still be a process. But the blessing from a father to a son gives him the vital things, the important things, the essential things, the things that he can use as a building block.